What's up, everyone? Welcome to this episode of DraftKings Tournament Plays presented by No House Advantage. All new users to No House Advantage receive a $25 deposit bonus with the code AWESOMO. Today, we're going to take a look at five of the best tournament plays on DraftKings. Keep in mind that we have an eight-game slate today with a lot of moving parts. This is the first day that the NBA is testing all of their players, regardless of vaccination status or symptomatic, asymptomatic, whatever. They're all getting tested, so we're getting players ruled out pretty constantly throughout the afternoon. Be sure to check into the Deeper Dive show, the Live Before Lock show, for more up-to-date stuff. Also, a reminder with the tournament plays mentioned here, these aren't necessarily guys that should be your highest owned players. It's more so players that are projected to go under-owned. In some cases, they are likely to do really well, and maybe they should be some of your highest owned players. In other cases, it's more so when you're getting to the end of your lineup and you need a low-owned piece that still has some upside, you can, you know, fit these guys in. So if you're somebody playing one, two, three lineups a night, and you're not really sure, you know, you want to be contrarian, but you're not really sure exactly where to go, these are some guys that you can look to that are still solid plays, even at low ownership. Starting it out with number five on DraftKings, we have Miles Bridges at $7,700. Right now, he has an 11% chance of being in the optimal lineup. He's only 5% owned. Bridges is someone that isn't too negatively affected by Charlotte returning to full strength. He's averaged about 37 minutes per game this season, so there's no real reason to think that he's not going to play a lot of minutes even as they get bodies back. He's close to a full fantasy point per minute guy. He's in a good matchup against the Portland Trailblazers. Not the fastest team in the league, but not a good team defensively. He has small forward and power forward eligibility on DraftKings. Just looks like a guy that shouldn't get much ownership, but certainly should get a lot of playing time and is a pretty solid permanent fantasy producer. Coming in at number four, Clint Capella, projected for only 4% ownership with an 11% chance of being in tonight's optimal lineup. He was just downgraded to questionable with an illness, so certainly keep an eye on his status. But he's only $7,400 on DraftKings. He's going up against a Denver team that we know is going to give Nikola Jokic 34-plus minutes as long as the game's competitive. It's likely that Atlanta wants Capella on the floor for a lot of minutes tonight. So you're talking about a player that's very reasonably priced, that's averaged 1.13 DraftKings points per minute this season, and that is getting virtually no ownership. He is at a very deep center position. There's good value at the position today. There's Jokic as a pay-up option, who we know is always one of the best pay-up options. So it's going to be difficult to prioritize Capella, but looks like he's going a bit under-owned here compared to his chances of success on this slate. Coming in at number three, Pat Connaughton, projected for 9% ownership with a 13% chance of being in the optimal lineup. Chris Middleton is probable to return to the lineup, to the Bucks lineup tonight, but Bobby Portis is out. Giannis Antetokounmpo is still doubtful. They're missing a handful of other players. It's likely that Connaughton is in the starting lineup. It's likely that Connaughton plays 32-plus minutes. He's not the best per-minute fantasy producer, but he's averaged 0.83 DraftKings points per minute overall this season. If you take Giannis off the floor, Connaughton has averaged 0.81 DraftKings points per minute, so not a huge or not really any change in production, but there are more minutes available for him. You're going to see a lot of ownership go to Jrue Holiday on this team, a lot of ownership go to Chris Middleton, a lot go to DeMarcus Cousins. All of those guys are fine, but Pat Connaughton may be going a little bit overlooked in a good matchup against the New Orleans Pelicans. The number two tournament play on DraftKings, the other side of the Milwaukee game, Brandon Ingram, $8,700 with the very valuable shooting guard and small forward eligibility. He's projected for 8% ownership with a 13% chance of being in the optimal lineup. Ingram's been not great this season, but he is playing a lot of minutes. He's very, very involved offensively, as you would expect. He has a 30.3% usage rate. He's averaged 1.13 DraftKings points per minute this game, and he's likely to give you 36 to 37 minutes if this game is competitive. No Giannis should make life a little bit easier for Ingram as well. He's at a kind of difficult price point to get to, and that's why he's not projected for much ownership. But if you can find a way to get there, he certainly gives you a high ceiling while not too many people will have him in their lineups. And then rounding it out, going back to the Milwaukee side, certainly not someone that you really want to necessarily build your night around, but Grayson Allen looking like the number one tournament play right now. when you compare his chance of success to his projected ownership. 14% chance of success, 8% projected ownership. He's 4,300 with shooting guard and small forward eligibility. He's averaged 0.77 DraftKings points per minute this season. He's likely to play 30-plus minutes tonight with Milwaukee being shorthanded. Without Giannis on the floor, similar to Connaughton, no uptick in production for Grayson Allen. But again, those minutes should be there. So it's a good matchup against the Pelicans. It's a player that's going a little bit under-owned while people roster a lot of his teammates. Still a very, very good spot for Grayson Allen. So to recap, the top five tournament plays on DraftKings tonight. Number five, Miles Bridges. Number four, Clint Capella. Be sure to check on his status. He is currently listed as questionable with an illness. Number three, Pat Connaughton. Number two, Brandon Ingram. And rounding it out as the number one contrarian tournament play on the slate, Grayson Allen of the Milwaukee Bucks at $4,300.